Let's talk about machine learning operations, and also GPUs. One of the things that I teach at some of the top universities in the world, including Duke, is MLOps. And what I'm personally excited about is taking machine learning models out of the notebooks where they're stuck and putting them into production. And so one of the things that's exciting about Rust is it's the perfect language to do that. I've heard many people have some, you know, critiques about, you know, Rust versus Python, where they talk about how Python is one of the leading languages for machine learning. Well, what I'm going to show you is, in fact, some of that can be debunked. Rust is an amazing candidate for doing machine learning operations because it has bindings for some of the most popular things that you'd like to do. For example, PyTorch works in a trivial way with GPUs. In fact, you can take advantage of the fact that Rust can be up to 70 times faster for many operations, like on average. You also can take advantage of the binary portability of Rust. When you build a project from the beginning, it's production first. So a lot of people talk about production first mindset with Python, but wait, do you mean model portability? Do you mean binary portability? Oftentimes they're saying something, but the reality is it's a different scenario when you get into production. Rust is a production first mindset language because you can take a model, package it into a binary, and then push that into production. And that's really the advantage of using Rust for things like Hugging Face. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to dive into an example of how to build a lyrics analyzer that talks to a SQL database using Rust. And we're going to show how this can be combined into a command line tool. And in fact, if a company wanted to get founded on this premise, right, let's analyze lyrics, and they wanted to do this in an efficient way, Rust would be the ideal language versus Python because of the fact that it uses less energy, it uses less computational time, and also you can use multi-threaded programming that takes advantage of all the cores. So if you're going to analyze millions and millions of songs, for example, and you want it to summarize them or do zero-shot classification, you want to use a high-performance language. You don't want to use one of the slowest languages ever created. So that's really the idea here with Rust, is it's an amazing tool for high-performance MLOps, and I'm going to show you how to do it with Hugging Face. All right, let's go ahead and get started. Let's take a look at what I would call the canonical example of why Rust is so important for MLOps. Really, MLOps is about putting things in production. It doesn't matter if you train the model yourself or you're using another model. In this particular example, let's suppose that I'm a music company and I've got millions and millions of songs inside of my file storage system, and I want to use modern LLMs to really classify what's going on with my record collection and potentially make more money on it, or, you know, serve it out in a recommendation engine. So let's go ahead and take a look at what the architecture could look like. And in fact, a little bit later, we'll write through the code ourselves and actually have a reproducible example. First, I would say a SQL database that has some zero-shot candidates, you know, for example, rock, pop, hip-hop, country, Latin. You could put whatever you want inside of here, but the idea here is that you have some initial categories here. Next up, what you're going to need to do is take those millions of songs and transcribe them as quickly as possible and as efficiently as possible, right? You don't want to be burning millions of dollars to do the transcriptions. And this is exactly where a Rust-based approach makes a lot of sense. Rust has amazing performance for multi-threaded code. And if you wanted to crawl the file system, look at all the different songs there, and then transcribe them in an extremely memory efficient and computationally efficient way, this is the way you do that. Once you get those transcripts, then you could go in and pass that into, yet again, the Rust bindings for Hugging Face and do a zero-shot classification, and this would be the end result, and then you could potentially put that back inside of the SQL database. So this is a very real-world production system. In fact, maybe people are doing this already, but we're going to go through and build this ourselves. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. Let's take a look at how we're going to build this out. We're going to have some assistance here with Copilot to allow us to leverage the power of the Cargo ecosystem to really kind of supercharge things. First up, I'll go through, I'll build something in GitHub. I'm going to use these powerful CodeSpace instances. I'm also going to use this workflow of prompt, right, through prompt engineering, format, lint, test, run, deploy. And Copilot is going to be involved prompting us, and we're going to refine that by going through the traditional Cargo compiler. All right, so let's go ahead and get started here and take a look at the Rust crate. You can see here ready to use NLP pipelines and language models. And one of the things that I think is very important to point out, and I've heard different people talk about how there's not a lot of libraries for MLOps with Rust, but that's just not true. If we take a look at this, we have a crate here that allows you to use PyTorch. We also have the pre-processing from Rust tokenizers. And in fact, let's go take a look at the tokenizers here. And what's the first thing they say? Extremely fast thanks to Rust implementation. So Rust is heavily used in Hugging Face because of the performance advantages, right? It's a key MLOps capability. Likewise, if we go into Rust BERT here, you can see here that it's trivial, right? It looks just like Python in many ways, or at least the syntax is as concise as Python. And all we have to do is just copy this and get started with it. So let's go ahead and build this out inside of a new directory. So in order to do that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and open up a Codespace environment. All right, we have a Codespace here, and I'm gonna go ahead and create a new project. So I'll say cargo new, and we'll call this one SQLite HF, right, for Hugging Face. I'm gonna go ahead and CD into there, and it's gonna be pretty trivial for us to build out this structure. If I go through and take a look at this, all I need to do is paste in the correct cargo versions. Next up, all I need to do is also create a lib directory. Go ahead and do that. We'll go ahead and say touch lib.rs. I'm also gonna grab some lyrics for one of my favorite songs by Mana, and this will be something I'll throw inside of lyrics.txt. So we'll go ahead and put this inside. We'll say touch lyrics.txt. And then once I've got that, I can actually just paste it inside, and we can see these are the lyrics that I'm gonna guess were transcribed if we had millions and millions of documents and I used Whisper and I was a music company, right? We're just gonna build a simple prototype, but this prototype could scale out to millions of users. Next up, all I need to do is start building out my library code. And one of the things, again, that I would highlight here, actually this lib should be in there, so let's move the lib to the source. One of the things I'm gonna highlight here is the prompts are critical when you're using Copilot. I'm gonna develop our first prompt, and I'm gonna go ahead and just say this, Hugging Face library to analyze lyrics to songs and put them into a SQLite database. And then at this point, we could import the necessary libraries just to make things quick for a demo. I'm gonna import the things I know are useful. And then all I need to do here is go down and create my first zero shot candidates. So let's go through and do that, right? And you can look at the code here, pretty straightforward, right? I'm gonna do it in memory just again for a demo. In the real world, I would persist to disk, and I'm gonna insert inside zero shot candidates like rock songs, pop songs, hip hop songs. And then it's surprising, in fact, how simple it is to query a SQLite database in Rust. We can just go through here and let's take a look at the code really quick. Look, it looks a lot like Python. We just say get all zero shot candidates, return back a vector of strings, create a database, select the zero shot candidates, and then basically give us the result so we can do something with them. Now, to read the lyrics from a project here, I'm gonna go ahead and do that real quick. Let's go ahead and take a look at this. We just say read lyrics from a file and return a vector of strings. So again, once you start to get the feel of it, one of the things that's kind of fun about Rust is if you see this let, that's creating an immutable variable. And the reason why this is so critical when you create an immutable variable is that it is actually a safety mechanism that allows your code to be more robust. And then finally, we're almost done here. Now we can actually build out some things by using the Hugging Face ecosystem. So what would I do? Well, I could just go through here and say, you know, classify lyrics like that. And we're gonna say it's gonna take a vector of strings, and really a vector of strings is just a mutable list if you're a Python person, and inside we have a bunch of strings, right? So it's really a similar concept. And then I could just go through here and, you know, build out whatever the structure that I need to build. You can see here it does a great job. We could even do a make lint if we want to, right? And that would go through and double check that everything's working. There we go. We were able to successfully classify the lyrics for this song from Mana. All right. That's it for today.